A pleasant good afternoon, everyone, and thank you so much for joining us. Today, we continue the celebration as we honor the icon, our hero. We recognize him as a giant in our community, Dr. Athniel Addie Ottley. We celebrate his life, his impact, accomplishments, and his legacy. Now, today we're going to name a road in his honor, and this road is so special. It served as a connection for the people of the Virgin Islands to him, to the People's Station, WSTA, that served as home of inspiration, the home of information, and of course, this is where we were able to hear that golden voice. And interestingly enough, I actually heard the commissioner made a reference, and I too was going to highlight that, that directly across from WSTA, formerly AP Sales, where WTJX used to have their home, their studio, where we enjoyed face-to-face, and Addie Ottley as well. So ladies and gentlemen, we thank you so much for being a part of today's event. My name is Shayla Solomon, and I am so honored to be a part of the event. Today is truly meaningful, and over the past few days, we have heard so many in our community share memories of the times that they have shared with Addie. We unanimously refer to him as a giant of a man, an icon who will forever remain a part of our history. Time, please allow me to introduce to you our platform guests, and please hold your applause until the end. The Governor of the U.S. Virgin Islands, the Honorable Albert Bryan Jr., the Lieutenant Governor of the Virgin Islands, the Honorable Genza A. Roach Esquire, President of the 34th Legislature of the Virgin Islands, the Honorable Donna Fred Gregory, and Senator Dwayne DeGraff. I'd also like to recognize all members of the 34th Legislature in our audience today. We have our Commissioner of the Department of Public Works, Honorable Derek Gabriel, and I would like to recognize all distinguished members of the Governor's Cabinet and his senior staff. Also joining us today, we have Bishop Jerome Fijo of the Saints Peter and Paul Catholic Cathedral. And I'd also like to recognize all other members of the clergy who may be present. I certainly would like to take a moment to recognize, and I would ask if you can stand, please, all members of Mr. Ottley's family, his children, his wife, his grandchildren. On stage, we have his granddaughter, Danielle, friends and family, all members of his family, please stand. And now, yes, you can give everyone a round of applause. Thank you so much, and you may be seated.
Gracious God, we come to you today in praise and thanksgiving. We praise you for your goodness, goodness to us all here in the Virgin Islands. We thank you for the manifestations of your love in our lives individually and collectively. As we gather in this place, dear Lord, we thank you especially for the gift that you have given us, the gift of Addie Ottley. We give you thanks for this glorious day, for the breeze that we are already having in this place, for those who organized and dedicated this roadway as the Athniel C. Addie Ottley Drive. May this new path in the heart of St. Thomas be an ever-present reminder that as we face difficult times, we are reminded of the love Addie had for the Virgin Islands and draw from his tenacity, love, and courage. Let the Annual C. Addie Ottley Drive remind us of a great man who understood clearly and believed passionately that it was not race or ethnicity that makes a person great, but the will to aspire for excellence, to run the race that is set before us and achieve the greatness you intend for all of us. Help us to emulate Addie by striving to be beacons of hope and standing up for what is right, even when we feel that we are standing alone. May the Athniel C at the Ottley Drive call out of us a renewed commitment to work for and achieve the best we can, not only for ourselves, but for the people of the Virgin Islands. We make this prayer through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. He who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you so much. You may be seated. And did you all notice that we had those showers of blessings earlier, and now it held up for today's event? Indeed, this is going to be a blessed event. I think this is such an exciting moment for us. The legacy will certainly continue. And what we're going to do is hear from our commissioner of the Department of Public Works for some opening remarks. And I join to the podium, asked to join me at the podium, the Honorable Derek Gabriel, Commissioner of the Department of Public Works.
Good afternoon, everyone. Of course, I want to extend a heartfelt welcome to the Honorable Governor of the U.S. Virgin Islands, Governor Albert Bryan Jr., the Honorable Lieutenant Governor of the Virgin Islands, Lieutenant Governor Tregenza Roach, Madam President of the 34th Legislature of the Virgin Islands, Honorable Donna Fred Gregory, other members of the 34th Legislature in attendance, and of course, our past senators, Reverend Clergy. A special shout out to the sponsor of this bill, who also is joining us on the podium, on this stage, Dwayne DeGraff. Friends, and of course, family of the late Athniel C. Addie Ottley. So, for me, this was a little difficult as I sat down several times to try to prepare remarks. I know today I'm begging your indulgence to keep on my shade just in case, you know, some water happens to drip down. But Addie was a personal friend of my mom's, both Addie and Mary. And one of my lasting memories of him was actually one of the last memories I have with the three of them, which was, oddly enough, Governor, Lieutenant Governor, at one of your food sales. And as we were there and we had conversations, you got to see these individuals just in their true element, just being happy and joyful and boastful about all the times that they had spent through life, right? And for me, I often think about those because it was some of the times where I saw my mother smile the brightest. They were personal friends, but more importantly, they shared a love for the Virgin Islands. They shared a love for our culture, especially carnival. They shared a deep, sincere appreciation for all that these Virgin Islands have done for everyone. But most importantly, they wanted to make sure that future generations always had an avenue not only to share their talents, but also to be recognized. And today, that's one of the things that I sticks with me. Everything that Addie did, as much as we call him a giant and an icon, he recognized the individual person. In those conversations, you felt like you were the most important person in the world at that moment. Whether he was speaking to you over the radio, whether it was in the face-to-face television show, he came into our homes every day and most nights for all my life. I mean, right here we have his granddaughter, Danielle. Nobody knows her last name, but everybody knows this young lady because she grew up over our airwaves. I mean, it really is a tremendous testament to who Addie was. But more importantly, and I'm going to say this, for my friend on the stage, he was a Sabanero. He was a Sabanero, and he was somebody that really just, I mean, when you look at his name, a name means something, right, Lieutenant Governor? A name means something. His middle name was Callistus. I want to say that one more time, Callistus. It's a strong name. Those are names that mean something and that show a man is larger than simply the legacy that he leaves, but the legacy that he leaves for generations to come. The legacy that he shows with his granddaughter, the legacy of each and every one of you, not only his children, but his grandchildren, his nephews, his nieces, his family, but all of us here in the Virgin Islands. We are truly his lasting legacy. So today, as we name this road after the Honorable Dr. Athniel C. Addie Ottley, I ask that again, each of us really try to strive and take on his legacy and make this Virgin Islands the best place that we can for future generations. The last thing, if anybody knows me, they know I love to give gifts. So I am going to ask his granddaughter, to join me one quick moment. And I do, on behalf of the Department of Public Works and our grateful people of the territory, I just want to present this gift to you. It is you can pull it out. It's a small version of the sign that is to come. Because every time you get to look at that, you know that your grandfather made a difference here in this territory. Thank you. Thank you guys once again. Welcome. And we look forward to an awesome ceremony in the honor of a tremendous giant. Thank you. All right. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner. And I can certainly remember Carnival, and I will miss hearing him say, let's take it down to Shayla for an interview, and also saying, back to you, Addie and Lily. Carnival with WTJX and Addie, that was a tradition. Everyone looked forward to that, face-to-face as well. And I was honored when I got a call one day that said, Addie wants you to fill in for a few face-to-face shows. I said, me? Well, of course. And I really wanted to make sure that I could make him proud. So your words are so fitting, Commissioner Gabriel, because he certainly saw the potential and he was willing to take the time to groom and teach so that if you loved communications, if you love media, he would put you on the right path. So we're going to continue in our program, and I'd like to call for remarks the Honorable Dwayne DeGraff, Senator of the 34th Legislature.
Thank you very much, Bishop Fujio, Governor, Lieutenant Governor, Senate President, colleagues of the 34th Legislature, past colleagues, Governor's Cabinet, family, welcome. And I say family welcome because Savanero's in the house. And I again, that was the impetus of the bill. Not only just having a Savanero, having a great Savanero to light the torch, keep it going. And I'm a proud Savanero. I went to Iraq and they talk about Savan, so I'm a proud Savanero. Now, in the booklet, you have a copy of the bill. I won't go through the reading of the bill because it was done. The information was put out several times, but one amendment I'd like to add to it is when Dr. Addie was knighted, they add the word Savanero. When he was honored as a doctor, add the word Savanero. And for this sign, someplace we're going to get Savanero put on the road sign. Okay? And I would just like to let you know how this came about. It was two versions of this bill that I had. Plan A was to name the Subbase Road after Addie. It was started by the Pueblo in Subbase, and it goes down to the foot of Sarah Hill. Sarah Hill Road is where we are at now. Plan B of this plan was Silkigata in Savan. Silkigata significance is that's the road that joined North City Vibe, where his parents' house is, and Gasigata, where he first started his little radio station in the basement of the house on Gasigata number 1. So Addie said he wanted Subbase Road because it comes in front of the station. The only caveat he wanted to name it was, at the end of it, he wanted Boulevard. You know, Addie said he wanted big. But, you know, if they put the road or street. So that was it. Now, at the beginning of 2021, the bill was, I informed him that I was putting the bill on, and he asked me, well, he basically told me, you know, there are a lot more important things going on in the beginning of the 34th legislature. Put me on the back burner, address these issues, and then we could go from there. So I waited a couple months and I just brought it out. But, you know, in speaking to him, he was very much excited. Call him on the radio and say he's going before this this committee. And when my colleagues at the 34th legislature voted unanimously on passing it and now make it law, thank you to my colleagues. Thank you to the governor for signing it into law. It's history. And when I talk about Savanero, my house, the Ottley's house would be where this podium is. My house would be where the speaker is. That's how close we are. So when Alan and Andre came in from the States and they, we all got together as boys and they talk a secret up in Miss Iris' house, figuring they're going to get us down in my mother's house, we could have heard them. That's how close we are. So, you know, so it's, and Andre, you know it. You know how we grew up. But again, we have it done. You know, Addie's here in spirit. I could feel it. I know it. Angela, thank you. Because we, you know, we've been talking back and forth. Mary, thanks for taking care of him. And to the family, thank you for allowing the community and the people of the Virgin Islands and the world to have Addie Ottley. Okay, because he wasn't just yours. He was ours. He was everybody's own. So thank you very much for that. Thank you to the governor. And thank you to Public Works. Commissioner Gabriel knows that he had been calling him and he'll say, hey, we can get this here done. Deputy Commissioner, Mr. Isaac, you know, we walked the route to make sure we're going to put where the signs are going and everything. So again, it was a collaboration of this event. So thank you very much. And Madam, thank you very much. Thank you for the time.
Thank you, Senator. We will now have the opportunity to hear from the granddaughter of our late, great Dr. Ottley. And I'm so honored to see her today because she was a member of the Graffiti Street cast when I was able to work with those group of students. And it's so good to see you back home. And we're going to hear some remarks from Danielle Greenwich, granddaughter of Addie Ottley. Also known as no last name, Danielle, granddaughter of Addie.
Thank you so much, Shayla. Fun fact, I actually succeeded you as host, so thank you so much for passing that torch. Hello, I am Danielle. No last name, apparently, but best known as Addie Ottley's granddaughter. I was the little girl, yes, who said, hey, granddaddy, this is the person who wins the birthday cake. And several of you have already told me as I was parading around town for the funeral occasion, so thank you for the reminder. Today I'm here to represent the Ottley family on this remarkable occasion. This is an amazing honor. My grandfather drove on this lane countless of times on his way back and forth to the radio station or to up the hill up WTJX TV. And he would be so humbled and excited to now have this named in his honor. To commemorate his journey back and forth. My grandfather made it clear how much the community meant to him, from adopting classes at Leonard Dobert Elementary to faithfully promoting locally owned businesses and initiatives. We were very proud of him, obviously, in his contributions to the community, but that did not come without sacrifice from my grandmother and from our family for him to be everywhere at the same time. Now that I'm older, I recognize that he was a man who had a higher purpose, and he was meant to be shared with everybody because the extended Virgin Islands family was his family. Since his passing, all of the love and dedication that he put into our islands has been poured back into us, and the support has really been overwhelming. His absence has obviously left a void in this community, and it will take all of us to fill and walk in his footsteps. In that interest, on behalf of the family, I'm proud to announce that we're working in conjunction with UVI to establish the Athniel C. Addie Ottley Scholarship Program. In which eligible high schoolers advancing to seniors will be able to go to UVI. So we're very proud of that. On behalf of my husband and my son Jackson, I am personally pledging $1,000 to begin this foundation. And if any of you are willing to also donate, Please make all checks payable to the Institution of Advancement Department at UVI. And also, please let this drive serve as a reminder of his service. And when you commute on the Athniel C. Addie Ottley Drive, please ask yourself, how can I also be of service and follow his example? On behalf of my grandmother, Mary, and the Ottley family, thank you again for this distinction. It's a testament to his dedication to this community and will forever cement his legacy so that future generations will know him and remember his service. Thank you so much.
Thank you so, so much. And while we're saying thanks, I know that the commissioner really wanted to acknowledge his staff at the Department of Public Works, everyone who worked tirelessly to make this possible, and of course, Government House, not only for this event, but for the road naming in itself. At this time, and please don't think that I skipped over Lorna's musical performance. Lorna's performance will follow our speeches. I know some of you were giving me the side eye. I love her and her voice as well. But up next, we're going to hear remarks from our Senate President of the 34th Legislature of the Virgin Islands, the Honorable Donna Fred Gregory.
Commissioner, it seems like you are always setting me up, you know. This is an inside joke. Every single time I come for a public works road naming, it rains just like this when it's my time to speak. That's why I made sure that I wore a long skirt today, so we don't have any issues. This is not a joke. You know, this afternoon is with mixed emotions that I greet you. I consider myself very privileged in such a time as this to be representing the 34th Legislature of the Virgin Islands as we dedicate and name this portion of the roadway in honor of the Honorable Dr. Athniel C. Ottley. Good afternoon again. You know, during the celebration of his life at the University of the Virgin Islands earlier this week, I said, and it bears repeating, Addie encapsulated the essence of the Virgin Islands. His unique and distinctive voice and personality embodied the spirit of the Virgin Islands that he loved and we love so dearly. It is fitting that we honor and remember those who have given so much of themselves. Much has been said over the last few days as we celebrated the life and legacy of this great Virgin Islander, this great icon, this great legend in his own right. And much, much will be said about him for days, weeks, and years to come. That is why this road naming, this is insane, is so important as it memorializes, his name so that locals, visitors, and future generations of Virgin Islanders to come will be gently reminded of this legend as they traverse this roadway. You know, I would be remiss if I did not recognize the sponsor of this legislation. And we heard him earlier, a proud Sabanero. I don't understand why I'm not a Sabanero, because you're my cousin. I don't understand. I got to figure that one out. I'm an Estril. You're my cousin. So this time I'm going to ask Senator DeGraff to come up again. As we present the permit plaque, a copy of the Act Number 34-0064. No Act, well, Bill Number 34-0064. No Act Number 8509. This permit plaque will be presented to Mrs. Mary Ottley, his widow, and to the family of Addie Ottley, which says in part, we're not going to read the entire thing, the legislature of the Virgin Islands, on behalf of the people of the Virgin Islands, honors and commends the Honorable, we have to amend it again, Dr. Athniel C. Addie Ottley, for his service to the people of the Virgin Islands through his years of broadcasting and dedicated public service and culture bearing for the people of the Virgin Islands and the entire Caribbean. In honor of the Honorable Athniel C. Ottley, outstanding accomplishments and contributions to the people of the Virgin Islands, and for his tireless broadcasting on radio and television of natural disasters and cultural and community events, the roadway beginning at the Pueblo Supermarket intersection junction and ending at the school lunch. I didn't know school lunch had an intersection, but it says ending at the school lunch intersection junction, Subbase, on the island of St. Thomas, is hereby named the Athniel C. Addie Ottley Drive. So Mary, we present you with this permaplaque. Yes, the picture was a picture that we blew up yesterday, so we want to also give it to the family. And we'd like to take a picture with you, if you would. Yes, please. Again, on behalf of my colleagues, we want to offer our condolences to the family. And I think we know that Athniel C. Addie Ottley will be etched, is etched in the minds of all Virgin Islanders now and for future generations. Thank you and God bless you.
Thank you so much, Senate President, and I echo the sentiments about the rain and the wind. That day for the Veterans Drive opening, that was, listen. So I know that, yes, from right there, perfect, Lorna is going to render a musical selection for us. I am going to keep my promise. You will get to hear her beautiful voice again. Lorna, the mic and the floor is yours.
It must have been cold there in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You content to let me shine, that's your way. You always walk a step beyond. So I was the one with all the glory. While you were the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name for so long. Beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. And I can fly higher than an eagle. Cause you are the wind beneath my wings. It might have appeared to go unnoticed, but I've got it all here in my heart. I want you to know the truth. Of course I know it. I would be nothing without you. No. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. My wings. Did I ever tell you you're my hero? You're everything, everything I wish I could be. Oh, and I can fly higher than an eagle. Cause you my wings, Addie Ottley, you are the wind beneath my wings. Addie, fly, Addie, fly, Addie, fly, fly.
Lorna, you are a blessing. Your voice is a blessing. We thank you. We appreciate you. My day is complete. My day is absolutely complete. But I need you to stop making me cry, Lorna. Please stop, okay? You're messing up everything here, Lorna. So before I call up the Lieutenant Governor, I asked him the other day if I could borrow, because we don't steal, borrow one of his quotes from the other day, because I got goosebumps when he said it. So I'd like to share this quote with you from the LT, borrowing it from him before I actually introduce him to you. And he said that this priceless contributions by this giant of a man would make his presence in this territory a timeless one, a memory and a legacy that we will cherish for a very long time. Hopefully forever. And all that we can ask is that when we are finished with this passage, that someone speaks of us, given a memorial that we deserve, as in this instance we're doing. Given him the memorial that he deserves for treasuring this place and keeping it safe so that we could inherit it and grasp the responsibility of giving it to another generation. Truer words could not be spoken. Dr. Ottley certainly left a legacy for not only my generation, the next generation, and countless generations to come. And this sign is just going to be one of the many reminders that we have and that we will share and that we will hold on to. So again, on behalf of everyone, to the entire family, thank you for giving him to us because we loved him. Same way you loved him, we loved him. And now I'd like to call for his remarks. After borrowing that quote from you, LT, I'll turn the microphone over to you. The Lieutenant Governor of the Virgin Islands, the Honorable Tregenza A. Roach, Esquire.
Thank you, Sheila. Good afternoon. And thank you, Lorna Freeman. Lorna is my personal songstress, so I only share her with the rest of the territory and the world. Good afternoon, Governor. How are you doing? She always discombobulates me, so I have to catch myself. Good afternoon to the Senate President, Donna Fred Gregory, to the members of the 34th Legislature present, Senator Johnson, Senator Joseph, Senator at Large Payne, and I see former Senators Myron Jackson and James O'Brien in the audience as well. Good afternoon to Bishop Fugeau. I'm sorry, Bill Sponsor, Senator DeGraff as well. To all the members of the Governor's Cabinet, especially this afternoon to the family of Addie Ottley and all Virgin Islanders gathered for this ceremony. And to those listening and viewing. Very often it is said that you don't get two bites of the apple. But since it's Addie's week, we get to a second opportunity to say some of the things that we were challenged to fit into the few moments that we had the other day. And one of the things that I wanted to share was how impressed I was with the merchants on Main Street. Because we know that those of us who've lived here, that when a funeral went down Main Street, the doors were closed, the staff and others came outside to witness the passing. And we all lamented, like Addie did, how this place has changed and how that element of the funeral protocols had gone missing. And so it was so wonderful to see such a uniform response of all those doors closing and all of those employees and owners and visitors standing in reverence as the funeral procession went by. And I really wanted to thank them publicly for that because I'm grateful to see a tradition carry on. I spoke about a couple of parallels in Addie's life and mine as a three-term senator, as Lieutenant Governor of the Virgin Islands. And the part that I didn't comment on at all was his role as a journalist. And he really performed that role in dual capacities, perhaps more than two, on the radio and in his interviews at WTJX, as Sheila pointed out, when it was right there on the Hill. And one of the things that I think was Myron started to talk about Addie's voice in the eulogy. And what I remember about his voice and what I will keep about his voice and his manner fit three words: precise, impeccable, measured, right? And in using this voice and using it in this manner, he was a witness to what we were passing through. He understood the role of the narrator, and he understood the role of the narrative. And he was precise in his delivery of his commentary and his remarks in every instance. And even though we've spent a week celebrating him, and so many words have been said about him and on his behalf, I do want to emphasize that we too are in this role of witness. And I'm so happy that we have all lived up to witness his life and to speak of his life in the same precise, impeccable and measured way that he deserves. I wrote a book called The Blessing of Rain, so I can't run from the rain. I just have to take it. But I just wanted to thank everybody for coming out this afternoon, and I just want to say God bless the family for having lent him and shared him with us. We are a grateful community, and we will honor his legacy for time to come, time immemorial. God bless each and every one of you. God bless the Virgin Islands. Thank you, Shayla.
We're going to do things a little bit differently because of the rain. Governor, see you right now. And ladies and gentlemen, please allow me to join for his remarks, the Governor of the United States Virgin Islands, the Honorable Albert Bryan Jr.
Thank y'all for coming out. Good night. Good afternoon, Lieutenant Governor Chigenza Rhodes. Good afternoon, Senate President Donna Fred Gregory, Danielle with no last name, Commissioner Gabriel, Senator Dwayne DeGraff, Savanero, Neva, Bishop Fujo, Mary, Robbie, family and friends, Angie, everybody. I was sitting there thinking how two things. First, I was saying every time I hope the rain stops, right? Because of course I was going to take my little job at Donna and say, every time she speak, it rain, and every time I speak, the sun come out. But it didn't work quite though. But you see, stopping though. Here comes the sun. It's all right. But I was also sitting there thinking, you know, when Addie, I wish the only thing missing from this week actually is Addie, because he would have loved this here today. Rain, sunshine, or snow, Addie would have loved us named this street naming today. And I thought to myself, he would call me, and you know, in politics, you treat your family the worst. So when they call you for an appointment or they want to talk to you, be like, yeah, man, I ain't get to you, man. They're going to come. Don't worry about it, you know? And I said he must have had a good laugh this week, boy, because he dominated about 10 hours of my week. You didn't want to talk to me while I was living. So you're going to talk to me while I'm beyond. But he must be smiling. And as I, every one of these things I go, you know, I learn a little bit more, and it gets a little bit richer about his whole experience of life. And sitting there, when I thought about all the time, because for me, I really wish I could cut all my meetings to a half an hour because I have so much things to do. But you know, you got to, when you people come in, you got to talk about your granny and where you come from. And that's a half an hour already by the time they get to the family before you get to business. But Addie got a lot of time this week because he earned it. He earned it. And I think a lot of people don't realize in today's world, they want everything to come quick and easy. They want to have immediate gratification when they haven't put in the work. And when you have a man like this, we take a whole week out and dedicate our time to honor him in his correct way, and we'll continue to do that down Athniel, Addie, Lucky Lane. It's because he's earned it. He didn't earn it just because. I wanted his friend from college. I can't remember your name. What's your name? Huh? David. Son of David. I want David talk about Addie meeting him in Indiana. Like, that had to have been like 60 years ago. Like 60 years ago. And see coming up here? And had a friendship that was worth him coming from Colorado. He didn't just come to one event, you know, he's been to everything. That's what he meant to him and his family. And apparently, you know, his family's busy. He came alone to the Virgin Islands to make sure that he represented for his friend. Thank you, David. Thank you.
People often talk about public life and what you've done in public life, or whether you are elected, and yes, he was chosen by the people to be a senator 3 times, and he was chosen to be a lieutenant governor. But when I look at his contribution here, whether it's a Right Coast Senate of the Arts, United Negro College Fund, yeah, I even forget when Addie used to do this, the telethons on TV, muscular dystrophy, civil liaison officer for the Virgin Islands National Guard, Chamber of Commerce, Phi Kappa Theta, Mental Health Commission, Arts Alive, Rotary. This is only some of the things that Addie did and contributed to in his life. He earned it. That's the page I think we need to take out of the book. You have a lot of people who want accolades these days, but they haven't earned it. They haven't earned the respect of the people. Addie's greatest service to the people of the Virgin Islands was just a voice through the night. I remember in Maryland when the windows were blowing out, and you go, the phones went. That was the blessing of a bad hurricane. But in Maryland, the phone stays up. And people calling the radio station, crying and bawling. People waking up the morning and everything gone. Addie was there. You can see Peter had to cuss him to go to sleep. To go to sleep. And when I think about this week and the pace that we've kept with all of the different events, that was Addie every day, from morning till night going. It's indicative of the dedication that he had to the people of this community. He didn't want anybody to call his name or feel good about him or raise him up above their shoulders. He just wanted to love people and to help. And if nothing else we take, and I used to tell my employees this all the time. If nothing else you do, just help. You know, if somebody comes in, just help and spread a little love and cheer. You know, I was so frightened because Robbie was by my house the day. Y'all know Addie loves sweets, right? Y'all didn't know that. Addie fell down by the bakery in St. Croix, picking up titty bread. And my first thought was, wow, is he all right? And my second thought is, wow, if St. Tomian didn't like Crucian before he dead, no, can we kill Addie? But they managed to get him. He wasn't okay, but he got taken care of. But because of that, today we're sharing some sweets, some local sweets from St. Croix. We have those to share with you in memory of Addie and all that he is, you know, just a little taste of that. And it's so fitting that he got a street named after him because, you know, Addie was a sharp boy back in the day. Addie had a first car that I know with a roll-on windows electric. Remember, Robbie was sitting in the car, Andre playing with the windows for hours. He had a, remember the Cressida? He had a nice Toyota Cressida. Huh? Oh, Cressida. Oh, it was French. But he always had a nice car, so. And I saw Derek fixing the road here. Not him personally, but his team fixing the road here, so it'll be nice, smart. So the Cressida don't mash up the tires. I am so glad that we're going to try to maintain this road and make it worth having the name Athniel Addie. And every time we come down this road, we remember beyond the blue horizon is the rising sun. And all we need to do is give a little love and a little help and it'll be a better Virgin Islands for all of us. Thank you. As the sun comes out, I'll depart.
It did indeed stop, Governor. It did indeed stop. Senate President, we'll have to figure out a system next time. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are now to the end of our program. It's been a wonderful day. Additional showers of blessings. And we thank you for being here. We thank you for what this means and this represents for the entire Virgin Islands. Yeah.